Yo, welcome back, YouTube. Rude Racing, my team. We got another episode here this week. We got Spain. We're gonna quickly go over kind of where we are with R&D here. So, as you can see, the game estimates were about middle of the pack, but we're pretty much tied with Alpine all the way down to Williams. So, the midfield here for this season is pretty even all the way across the board. Unfortunately for us, because this AI is pretty crazy. In terms of what we have in the pipeline right now, we have a major impact to the aerodynamics for rear downforce with the rear wing main plane being upgraded. And yeah, we've had some decent progress history. In terms of the constructors, where we stand right now, we have still the 10th and 11th place locked down and 5th place in the constructor standings. So nothing has changed since the last race in Miami, which was a terrible showing for us. So with that being said, I'm going to quickly do some quick practice, and then we're going to jump into qualifying. See you there. Alright, here we go. First flying lap. And we spin. Alright. Let's put on some new tires and try that again. Alright, attempt number two at that. That was just terrible first try, so let's redeem ourselves here. Oh, massive walk up! Horrendous time. Alright. Alright, we're in last place. We need one more good lap. We need just— oh, we're coming into a bunch of traffic. This is not fun. And that is good enough for still last place, so we're just going to try and go one more lap. Alright, so we put in a 117.2, and that is good enough for 22nd.
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again.
These people are putting in
115. Norris, Gasly, and Lewis
115.3.
With qualifying wrapped up now, we have our grid lineup for the big—
I don't know. I can't compete with anything near that. All right. We're going to try a different strategy out. We're going to try and go medium. We're going to try and go medium to soft. See if we can catch people at the end of their soft stint with some fresher mediums and see if that'll get us back into the race, because we are starting P20 here. As it looks like Guan Yu and Magnussen have taken the engine penalties. Alright, and we are live from Spain with 5 lights. And away we go. Not expecting a great start here, given we're on mediums and everyone else is on softs. We can hold Magnussen off here at least, which is a good sign. So we'll take that as a small win. And we have a little bit of space on the inside here up on Zhou Guanyu. We're going to take that. The back end does not want to cooperate with us here. This car is extremely oversteery. See if we can go around the outside of Piastri, maybe? We'll take a look, but it doesn't look like we're going to get it done. But we will send it up the inside here, and he leaves just enough space to grab onto us, but we get it done.
Okay, the start was fine. Let's try and move forward.
Next up is Latifi, and then the Aston Martins. As we head into the final corner, it looks like everyone else has grip except for us. which is not fun. But we do have some good straight line speed here right now, which is great. Because last week, we had almost none at Miami. Problem is, we have a high downforce configuration for this race today, yet we still have no grip. It looks like Piastri's trying to send it up the inside on us there. Piastri's gonna make a move around the outside. We're gonna park it on the apex there, and he's still gonna get it done. And he gets the move done on us. And Magnussen also is able to get past us, but we have that straight line speed advantage right now, so we'll go right past him. Take that right back. This car is just the absolute worst experience to drive, unfortunately. Tons of oversteer. So we just need to hope as these two guys try to take us on the main straight. One sec. And up the inside goes Joe Guanyu. He makes a little bit of contact. I left him the space, but for some reason he felt the need to make contact. Anyway, we just need to hope we can stay close here. Because eventually, these soft runners are going to start to fall off pretty quick. And at the end of the race, we'll have a lot more pace like they have on us. So we seem to start putting in some really good lap times here and catching back up. It's almost as if the AI has an unrealistic advantage through that last turn, because we cannot go flat out, but they can. And Joe Guanyu sends up the inside again, but we're going to switch back on him and make a beautiful move to make sure that he does not take that position. Is that all the confidence we needed to get things going here? Maybe.
Gap to the car in front is 6.6 seconds.
And there go the soft runners into the pits.
Science is in the pits.
Now we need to put in some really good laps. We missed the apex from a small lock up there, but it didn't hurt us too bad. Like the majority of the field, if not all of the field, is either in the pits or has already boxed, except for us. And there goes Science, sending it up the inside on us. We'll let him go. It's not our fight. Not today, at least.
Keep on him. He might make a mistake. The car ahead is 1.6 seconds.
We're starting to lock up a lot here. I think the tires are starting to fall off pretty bad, unfortunately. As well as we have a lot of pressure from these front-running teams. Yep, we have not much grip left. Oh. Meanwhile, Lando is putting up 1:17.
Just trying to drop back from the car in front by about 2 seconds a lap now. Get your head down. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 3.5 seconds. Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
So we're gonna dive in here and put on the softs. Because we need a lot of time to try and chip away this lead. Oh, geez, Sergio Perez coming in hot. And Sergio is on my naughty list from last week in qualifying where he cut us off. Alright, let's get a good stop. Put on softs. It is not looking good for us as I see the backrunners come across the final corner and we are screwed.
That was a fantastic stop.
And back into last place we go.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go.
But the good news is hopefully these tires are faster and we can start to catch people. Although I doubt it. Alright, so we're starting to gain time on these guys.
Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left.
We just put up our best lap of the race at a 1:18.7. 3 laps to go. We're starting to gain on everybody.
you've got plenty of energy, use the overtake bump and have a go. Come on, you can do this.
And now we put up a 118.4. And we're almost within a second of Joe Guanyu and Kevin Magnussen. As we go deep into turn one, unfortunately.
Right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps.
And we've officially gotten DRS now. Unfortunately, it looks like it's going to be just a little too late for our strategy here. We'll be able to send this one up the inside, but... No, we won't. Because Magnussen will. The Battle of Shame. Quite a good one. We're gonna send it at the inside here.
Nice work, mate. That brings you up a place.
So we gained one. We're not last place now, at least. Past Magnussen here. See ya. And after all of that,
okay, we've only got one lap of fuel.
We got a purple sector one. And Lando wins again. Oh, another terrible weekend. I'm sorry about the performance once more. We gotta find a way to get back in form.
And that's the end of the race. We'll see you
started 20th, race. Finished 20th. Absolute dud of a day. But, you know, there's probably some positives to be taken away from it. Unfortunately, our car just has absolutely no grip compared to the AI right now, so... Let's go look at the R&D real quick before we call it a day and see what we can maybe upgrade.
Let's have a look then at the driver's standings.
We got 19 mil. Our teammate costs quite a bit of money. So in terms of facilities, looking at what we can possibly upgrade right now. I'm going to increase our powertrain resource point generation. And then we're going to look at what we can do with 2,000 resource points here. So we have nothing available in powertrain. Nothing available, one thing available in reliability, can't afford it. Chassis, nothing available. And we have one thing available on aero, and we can afford it. So we're going to put on the Halo for major rear downforce again. Alright, yeah, thank you very much for watching. As the sign says, like and subscribe, and we'll catch you guys at the next race.